We saw previously how we can track qualitative changes of objects and events with quantitative measures based on indexes such as BVM. We will see now how we can use the same concepts and methods to reconstruct dynamical systems from disordered observations. We have here again an elementary cellular automaton, our favorite guinea pigs, to illustrate how algorithmic dynamics and our algorithmic causal calculus works. This is rule 254, which basically turns every cell black, producing a characteristic cone. The cone actually defines the region of influence of the initial condition. In other words, nothing outside the cone is affected by the initial condition, and the cone defines the only region that can be potentially causally influenced by the initial condition, both in space and time. Remember that time flows downwards. It is clear how a generating model for this cellular automaton would be short, and after applying any change to the cellular automaton, it would make the candidate model explaining the perturbed version longer and of greater algorithmic complexity. So the whole cellular automaton can be colored in red except for the last step. That is, because as we have seen before, the last step is of neutral nature, because the model generating the cellular automaton with or without the last step will be exactly the same. But after applying several bit perturbations to a row as marked in blue, then deleting such row would make the cellular automaton simpler. So now you can see how we can identify different parts of a dynamical system by making perturbation to different places, and identify different perturbations performed to such a system. Once shown how algorithmic information dynamics helps us to identify those elements and regions in a dynamical system, we can show you how this new interventional calculus can help us to reconstruct the space-time evolution of a dynamic system using, again, elementary cellular automata. Here are the regular space-time evolutions of a number of cellular automata rules, followed by a reconstructed space-time evolution from a randomly row-scrambled version of the same automaton. The reconstruction is done by identifying the lowest algorithmic complexity configuration among all possible 9 factorial row permutations, emulating all possible scrambled versions of the cellular automaton. That is for up to 8 steps plus the initial condition, hence 9. We are not showing the scrambled versions because it wouldn't make much sense. Just imagine we scramble them and we show you the result of the reconstruction process, reconstructed from a disordered version of the original evolution. The values at the bottom of each case are the Spearman correlation values between the original and reconstructed version. As you can see, correlation values are very high, most of them close to 1, meaning that we were able to almost fully reconstruct the original systems, or we were very close to do so. In all cases, we captured the qualitative dynamics even in those with low correlation value. So you can see here how you can capture something more fundamental and algorithmic than statistics, and correlation wouldn't be able to see it. Look at rules 57, 9, or 73. The reconstructed versions clearly captured some qualitative features of the original cellular automata, yet this is not reflected in the value of a Spearman correlation. But this other is the most striking result in the reconstruction of this cellular automata, because in the previous version, we reconstructed the space-time diagram, or we did so closely, but the results were not given the specific order of the evolution of the system, that is, which row was followed by which other. Here, however, instead of scrambling the original CA, or cellular automaton, we applied a perturbation to every row and tried to reconstruct the original cellular automaton by looking at how much and what type of effect would have each row perturbation on the original cellular automata. You can see again that the reconstruction is very close to the original unscrambled version of the cellular automaton. or the reconstruction is able to extract some key features of the data, such as in the cases of rules 11, 9, or 54. So in this case, we did not only be able to reconstruct the cellular automata, but we also have the exact sequence of time steps. And when putting together and considering more data, the reconstructions are even better. In figure C, for example, and as it would be theoretically predicted, the later in time a perturbation is performed, the less disruptive. Each pair shows the statistical rho and p values between the reconstructed and original spacetime evolutions, with some models separating the system into different apparent causal elements. In figure D is the reconstruction of one of the simplest elementary cellular automata, again rule 254, and in figure E, one of the most random looking ECA, both after 280 steps. In both cases, it is illustrated how the perturbation-based algorithmic calculus for model generation in two opposite behavioral cases actually reconstructs the cellular automata in some with some accuracy. In figures F and G, the accuracy of the reconstruction can be scaled up and improved at the cost of greater computational resources by going beyond single-row perturbation up to the power set, that is all the subsets of bits. Depicted here are reconstructions of random-looking cellular automata, such as rules 30, 73, running for 200 steps. And for experiments of a single row knockout or deletion, and double row deletion. Errors inherited from the decomposition method, or BDM, look like shadows in some of these cases, but as we have explained before, they can be counteracted by by measuring the numerical deviations from the boundary conditions, and thus they can be corrected. Variations of the magnitude of the effects are different in systems with different qualitative behaviors. The simpler the systems, the less different the effects of the deleterious perturbations at different times. But in non-trivial systems, different information perturbations, that is positive, negative, or neutral, have significantly different effects. And in those systems in which those effects were neutralized, they were so because systems were so simple that different types of perturbations were expected to have about the same effect in the candidate generating models. So, in this lecture, we have seen how powerful this algorithmic interventionist calculus based on algorithmic information dynamics can be at helping reconstructing models and systems behavior in a profound manner, tackling the challenge of causation. In the next lecture, we will now see how we can take advantage of this power not only to describe or study objects and find out models and causes for those objects, but to actually steer and manipulate systems.